Hi, good morning, everyone. It's really a fantastic morning today, especially when I landed at the airport. it was announced that it's almost 15 degrees. Very welcome departure from Mumbai, which is still at about maybe 26, 27 degrees even in the mornings. so when Ashish requested me to be a speaker for this session, I don't go typically by any presentations because presentations kind of, you know, compartmentalize you. Jo horse blinded approach hota hai, wo ho jata hai. And I typically am very freewheeling in terms of my talk. But suddenly what happened is that this demonetization thing happened, and I remember I was in Hyderabad. My flight was at 7:30 to Mumbai, 7:45 I think. The flight got delayed and it exactly took off at 8:30, 8:35. So I had my mandatory rituals, yaar, market kaise band hua, ye wagera, and all those things. And I hung up, and obviously I was in the flight for a holy good 2 hours. Flight circling hote hue land hui 11 baje ko, and I had absolutely no clue what hit the universe or what hit India as a universe. And then I only know I had some 280, 290 odd WhatsApp messages. I had some more than 2 dozen missed calls. And as luck would have it, battery was on 10%, and that is the boon or bane, I don't know, of smartphones. I really don't know what is so smart about smartphones, because itna aap charge karke niklo fir bhi battery to puri drain ho jati hai. So I just managed to take one call, obviously, and I got a gist of the entire thing, and I said this is like completely jacked. Usually kya ho jati hai na aadat ki jaise bolte hai na petrol price hike from midnight to puri line lag jati hai petrol bharne ke liye, and this was effective from midnight that 500,000 rupees is not going to be legal tender. And I was like, oh my God, it's 1 hour to 12 o'clock. My driver is on leave. So I had to take a prepaid taxi from the airport, and it was international airport. So I was like, will this guy really take my 500 rupee note? As luck would have it, fortunately, the news had not traveled so far and so speedily, and he actually accepted my note. But the good news is, let me also tell you, today we are on 19th. 8th ko ye hua, 8th midnight, so 9th onwards. So 9th to 19th. Believe it or not, I have not withdrawn a single rupee from the bank. Not only not have withdrawn, but aisa nahi tha jeb mein kharch karne ke liye paise the. I was always more of a plastic money believer. The fact remains that till today I have not used a single rupee of money. So how did I do it? Obviously, credit cards. So anyways, I was using credit cards, debit cards, fund transfer. Drivers and maids, I had put them. I didn't have any sixth sense. Okay, it was just plain lucky. I typically tend to forget to withdraw money. So I told them, yaar, apne IFSC code de dena, I'll transfer money to you. So it was all sorted. I downloaded Paytm. On the 9th morning, I downloaded Paytm. And now 10 mein se 7 transactions I do through Paytm. So I think life has been very sorted. But over the course of the week, a lot of calls coming in. Yaar, ab kya hoga? Dunya band ho jayegi. Life will go to a standstill. Hum to ventilator pe chale jayenge. Lot such questions, lot such queries. And specifically, what is happening is, ye jo lending ka dhanda hota hai, NBFCs, banking, organized sector, unorganized sector, specifically the organized sector, because mutual funds deal only with the organized sector. So fear unke man mein ye tha, yaar, ki isse credit mein koi dikkat na aa jaye, because, you know, we are investing money in debt funds. So I thought probably it'll be opportune time for me to just run through some slides just to give you a sense here. The world has not come to an end as Nostradamus would have predicted. And it is N for Nostradamus, N for Narendra Modi, but he is not clearly that. So we don't have to worry about that. So that's why the presentation is also aptly titled Afraid of Credit Post Demonetization. So we know all this. I'm not running into this. But you know, ek cheez isme na, in this slide I want to tell you. I know that there are, so I'll tell you, I have two sets of stories, very 30-second stories. My maid and my driver were extremely happy. Yaar, bahut achha ho gaya, ye ho gaya. And you know, just a week before this, when I was chatting with my the lady at the gym, she said, yaar, achhe din kaha hai, madam, humko to mehngai to kami hoti hui nahi dikh rahi hai. So then I got talking to her and I told her, aap invest karte ho, mutual funds wagera. So she said, nahi, main insurance policy leti hu, jama karati hu, and all those things. And then subsequently when I met her after this demonetization, she was a very, very happy lady. And then flip it on the other side, I have a friend who's an architect friend. She's like, what the hell has happened to India? This is not done. This is not accepted. I'm so annoyed. These were her words. And 2 nights of sleepless, basically 2 nights were completely sleepless. So we have these two coteries. Both are residents of India, both are citizens of India, but see how it has impacted two different people. But why this slide is important is that यार हमको ना किसी को पता नहीं है, इधर यू और मी, एनी ऑफ अस सिटिंग इन दिस रूम, की हाउ मच ऑफ अनअकाउंटेड और पैरेलल मनी. एवरी कैश इन द सिस्टम इज नॉट ब्लैक मनी. लेट्स प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, हर चीज जो पैसे में घूम रही है, इवन यू नो इफ आई हैव सम 10,000 बक्स राइट नाउ इन माय पॉकेट, 500 रुपीज, इट्स नॉट ब्लैक मनी, इट्स कैश. सो कैश इज पैरेलल इकोनॉमी. 2001 में, 15 साल पहले, द कैश इकोनॉमी वॉज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 10% ऑफ द जीडीपी. Approximately, I'm not talking about black money, mind you. Okay, today as we speak, that cash component in the economy is almost 50%. So it was very important to curb that. Ab, I am not getting into modus operandi and getting into political turmoil. Yaar, ye barabar hua, nahi hua. So the importance of curbing that from a financial market perspective is therefore very, very important. And we all know this. In fact, ye jo paisa jama hua hai, 3% of the money has been deposited by Jammu and Kashmir. So you can imagine, ye jo terror funding, ye jo narcissist extremist funding hota hai, it's an estimate that 50 se 60 hazar crore is this kind of funding, extremist or narcissist funding, jo cash mein hota hai. So effectively that impacts people like you and me, honest people like you and me. So it was very, very important to nip in bud the thing. Main ye nahi keh rahi hu kal ja ke ye hoga hi nahi. We are not like Sweden. By the way, just for you and me, Sweden is a cashless economy. वहां पे कैश का एक रुपये का धंधा नहीं होता है, बट ऑफकोर्स वी आर नॉट स्वीडन, इट्स एब्सोल्युटली फाइन. सो दिस विल क्लियरली बी अ गेम चेंजर फ्रॉम दैट पर्सपेक्टिव. व्हाट इज द इमीडिएट इम्पैक्ट? आप तो कोई भी, नाउ ऑल्सो आई वाज रीडिंग द टाइम्स वाइल इन द फ्लाइट, एंड 75% डाउन, यहां पे ये हुआ, वहां पे सुइसाइड हुआ. यार मुझे ये समझ में नहीं आता, अगर किसी को हार्ट की प्रॉब्लम थी, किसी को बीपी का प्रॉब्लम था, अगर वो धूप में खड़ा हुआ, आई एम नॉट ट्राइंग टू बी नॉन इमोशनल हियर, बट इट इज वेरी इजी टू लिंक अनरिलेटेड थिंग्स और यू नो सुपरस्टिशियस थिंग्स, यार यार काली बिल्ली ने रास्ता काट दिया और उस वजह से हमारा ये हुआ. यार तुमको जो होना था वो होके रहेगा आपको. यार कम ऑन, यू कैन नॉट लिंक अ हेल्थ इश्यू एंड से दैट ओके दिस हैपेंड बिकॉज ही और शी वाज इन क्यू. सो इमीडिएट इम्पैक्ट, ऑब्वियसली आई एम नॉट डिनाइंग देयर विल बी क्लियरली अ नियर टर्म इम्पैक्ट. इनफैक्ट आई वाज इन कोचिंग टू डेज बैक, मीटिंग प्रोमिनेंट लेंडर्स, तो वहां पे थोड़ा लेंडिंग कम हुआ है. तो एक बंदा था जिसने बताया, माय कलेक्शन, डेली कलेक्शन, एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द लेंडर्स, गोल्ड लोन लेंडर्स, माय डेली कलेक्शन, जो इंटरेस्ट का कलेक्शन है, वॉज 10 crore ऑफ रुपीज अ डे. दैट केम डाउन टू 1 crore. But today, as we speak right now, that number has come up to 8 crores. So, ये जो होता है ना, teething trouble होता है. There is a teething trouble, and that teething trouble, just assume, you know, and यहाँ पे Delhi board, so for example, ICSE board. Assuming you are moving in Bombay, for example, you are moving from SSE board to ICSE board. Or worst case, SSE board to IGCSE, IB board. तो जो टीदिंग ट्रबल होता है, जो सिलेबस चेंज, जैसे हम बोलते हैं दैट सिलेबस चेंज इज व्हाट इज इंपैक्टिंग. आई एम नॉट ट्राइंग टू बी लिटल द इशू, बट जस्ट ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन टू यू दिस इज अ प्योर टीदिंग ट्रबल, एंड वी विल क्लियरली सी द इंपैक्ट लिंगरिंग फॉर एटलीस्ट अ कपल ऑफ मंथ्स मोर, इफ नॉट लीस्ट. So that is broadly the impact of demonetization. I don't want to scare you with all these charts and stuff like that, but yaar, major industries or major sectors which we believe will get largely hit, or major asset classes predominantly. Abhi ye kya hota, land buying and selling was largely done in cash. 50 to 60% was cash component. So it is our estimate that that will come down. To mane jinhone bhi jo NBFCs hai, which have lent against property, loan against property, which is again land or something, agar unhone 100 rupaye ke against 85 ya 90 rupaye diye hain, they have to be worried. But the guys who have given 60-65 rupees against a 100 rupee exposure, absolutely no reason to be worried. Likewise, gold prices. Now, every person whom I spoke to next day said, gold to thuk jayega, yaar, rupiah mein to gold badh gaya, it increased by 40%. This is called Indian jugaad. Now, Indian jugaad is something which is not covered by any Indian economics, and obviously, I am not an expert to comment about that. But the fact of the matter is, globally, gold jo niche hai, that is for a different reason, and it is not because of demonetization. That is the Trump factor and not the demonetization factor. So I think broadly, it is asset financiers, jo jaise maine aapko bataya, banking sector will not be significantly hit, because the cash in the portfolio was very, very insignificant. Cash ka dhanda hota nahi tha. Sauda hamesha check transaction ya online hota tha. It is the non-banking finance companies which we believe will have a predominant hit. But real estate, again, I have been meeting a lot of real estate developers over the last, and it is not demonetization related, generally over the last 1 month, because we at Kotak lend to real estate developers. The feeling that I got even then and now is that, look, we do 100% cash check transactions. So the developer or the primary market funding, we call it the primary market and secondary. Secondary is between you and me. Primary is between, say, me and the developer, or you and the developer. So, वहां पे जो हो रहा है ना, that is absolutely not impacted. इनफैक्ट वन ऑफ द प्रोमिनेंट डेवलपर्स, आई कांट टेक द नेम बिकॉज दिस इज बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड, आई एम टोल्ड डिड अ कैश सेल्स ऑफ 300 crores, एंड हम यहां पे बोले जा रहे हैं दिस इज गोइंग टू बी डूम्सडे फॉर रियल एस्टेट. आई अग्री इट इज गोइंग टू बी ऑब्वियसली सेंटिमेंट वाइज नेगेटिव फॉर रियल एस्टेट, बट एवरीथिंग इज ओनली इन द इंटरिम. इवन द बिग टिकेट साइजेस, सो देर इज पेडा रोड इन मुंबई विच इज लाइक अप मार्केट साउथ बॉम्बे रीजन, अ वेरी पॉश लोकेलिटी, वहां पे टिकट साइजेस जो है 40 to 50 crores है. इवन दैट 40 to 50 crore टिकट साइजेस, प्रिडोमिनेंट अमाउंट ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन, प्राइमरी ट्रांजेक्शन माइंड यू, इज हैपनिंग वाया चेक पेमेंट. सो इज इट टू मच ऑफ हियर से, टू मच ऑफ ये जो हम बोलते हैं ना बात का बतंगड़ बनाना, अकॉर्डिंग टू अस दैट इज वॉट इज हैपनिंग. बिकॉज वेन आई गो डाउन एंड मीट डाउन द लाइन, द रियलिटी इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट. I came out of, I had an event yesterday for one of the bank's client meet, and after coming out from there, I was passing through the ATM. There were only 3 people standing at the ATM. This was about 10:30, 11 in the night. 3 people standing at the ATM. So I just casually inquired with that lady, yeah, ma'am, is the ATM working? She said, yeah, it's working. Absolutely fine. Yesterday, I had one of my colleagues who came in from Singapore airport. So he landed here and obviously he had to withdraw currency. And there were 3 ATMs, 2 were not working, but the 3rd one was working. So he said, yeah, I got my cash. So there is this side of the story also. What we only get carried away. Abhi kya hota na, aap jab Bombay land karte ho, to aapko dhara bhi dikhta hai, slum dikhta hai. So you believe that India is only a poor country, India is a slum country. But same thing if I flip it, but if you land in China, whether it is Shanghai airport or it's Beijing, what do you see? Only high-rise buildings and swanky things. Does it mean China mein poverty nahi hai? Absolutely not. China, rural India is full of poverty. Only thing is, jo dikhta hai, wo bikta hai. So my only request is, let's not get carried away by all these things, because there is more shore than actual literal. So jaise bolte na, empty vessels make more noise. There is more of that kind of a thing. Coming back to markets specifically, again, just trying to simplify these charts for you. 2008, Lehman collapsed. At that point in time, what happened? लोगों को लगा अगेन वर्ल्ड इज कम टू एन एंड. जैसे लेमन वॉज यू नो सम इंडियन कंपनी विच हैड गॉन बैंकरप्ट, पीपल थॉट दिस वर्ल्ड इज गोइंग टू कम टू एन एंड. World growth came to an end, it was completely derailed, and after that what happened we all know. The debt markets took up like nobody's business because interest rates had to be cut. We believe it was a very, very difficult time at that point in time because the world had gone into a slumber, because a bank which was systemically important was led to fail. I think that was the first ever time in history, and I don't think it will ever happen again in history. But where are we today? If you look at every aspect, and now let me just park demonetization for a bit. Agar aap ek fundamentally, if you see each of the numbers, so we are in 2016 November. 3 years back, if I would have addressed this gathering, the consumer price, jo inflation hai, mehngai jo hum bolte hai, which is impacting you and me, that was in double digits. Today it's at 4%. We are talking about interest rates, the real interest rate that you get after adjusting for jo inflation hai. So your bank say gives you X percent rate of return, 7%. If inflation is 7%, your real return is 0. So this real rate actually 3 years back was negative. Matlab aapka jo investment tha, that was not even allowing you to beat inflation. So you see each of these parameters in this chart that is displayed, each of these parameters are only better today. So I think from an India perspective, we are significantly better than what we were. So it is like this, you know, you go in movie parlance, I'm a movie buff also. So it is like this, you know, you actually go to a Ramsey horror movie and you end up actually laughing, which is what most of us do in theaters. That horror movies in Bollywood are hardly horror movies. They end up actually being a comedy thing. Good days for corporate bonds, we believe yes, because for the reasons that I mentioned, kya ho raha na, there is a lot of emphasis now in the last 10 days or 8 days or whatever the time period is, the banking system has collected close to 5 lakh crores. Ab ye jo paisa hai na, it is all stashed in the lockers and the currency chests of banks. So suddenly what happens is that you've inherited riches. Aapke paas bahut paisa ho gaya. So what do you do with that money? That money has to be spent. Where do you spend it? Right now the entire money is going to RBI. So RBI is taking out the entire liquidity. Later on, where will that money come? That money will be lent to people like you, to people like me. For what? For buying a house, for buying a car, for buying, say, a personal loan, for whatever, for your business. So then therefore we believe that because of that, the interest rates will come down quite dramatically, and the rate at which you are going to borrow today will be significantly lower than the rate at which you borrowed maybe 1 year back, and the rate at which you will borrow 1 year later will be significantly lower than the rate at which you borrow today. Meaning to say that interest rates are headed only on the lower direction. Now, a lot of people tell me, yaar, ab dekho, AAA safe hai. Sab log to paisa lagayenge penny stocks mein. I mean, those Z category stocks, jahan pe circuit upar ka, circuit niche ka, jiska koi ata pata thikana nahi, corporate governance ka issue nahi hai, we all love to dabble in those stocks. But the moment we tell you, yaar, yahan pe, you know, you have strategies, jahan pe aapka yield uptick wagera kar sa, dil se nahi, yaar, hum risk nahi lenge, hum bank FD mein laga denge. And that is precisely the reason today the banking industry is 100 lakh crores. It's thanks to people like you and me. 100 lakh crores for what? For one thing called assured rate of interest. Mutual funds cannot assure you a rate of interest. And that is the only reason why the mutual fund industry is at 16 lakh crores. Ab aap munche bataiye, and you can remove any arithmetic, be it debt fund, equity funds, jo bhi aap apne aankhde jod lena. When has bank FD outperformed mutual funds, be it on the debt side or on the equity side, on a 3 year basis, on a 5 year basis? So that is what this chart is trying to tell you, that you don't need to be afraid of credit. Credit is, bank is also lending to the same credit. Mutual funds are also lending to the same credit. In fact, better quality credit. But banks cannot, banks will assure you a rate of interest. So wo jo assurance ka jo price hota hai, that is way, way higher than what you and me can assume. And that is the reason. So as I colloquially put it, banking product is a pull product. Matlab, aap college graduation wagera khatam kar lo, naukri lag jati hai, pehli cheez what you have is a bank account. Koi account hona ho, you definitely have a bank account or salary account, right? You will never open a mutual fund folio, not necessary at all. At best, kisi ka dhakka maar liya, you will buy an insurance. So therefore, I believe every other product is actually a push product. But our study says, and we've done these analysis 15 saal, 20 saal ki history mein, koi bhi CRISIL rated AAA corporate hoga, it has A, never defaulted in the history. Point number one. But can I put all money in AAA? The answer is, can all the money be in large caps? No. I need some kicker. I need some extra return on my portfolio. So therefore, I will go down the rating curve. I will go to a AA. I will go to a AA plus. But can you say everything is bad? Answer is no. We all know Amitabh Bachchan is a superhero. Aisa zaruri nahi hai ki Amitabh Bachchan ki har picture hit hoti hai. And we all know Ayushman Khurana is not a superhero. Phir bhi Vicky Donor toh hit hui thi na. So the point I'm trying to say is that it doesn't mean that just because you are a small cap or a mid cap or a low rated company, doesn't mean that you will not be able to compete with a AAA. An example of movie, because I'm a movie buff. So just bear with me for that. So is the economy good and likely to do better? Yes, the answer is yes. Are we getting comfort from ratings? Ratings kya hota hai? GPS jo hoti hai na, GPS just tells you, gives you a broad indication ki aapko yahan se wahan pahunchna hai, to approximately kitni der mein pahunchoge. GPS is not 100% accurate. Hypothetically, if all of us in this room are going in a same direction, everybody has GPS on. So GPS as a technique just aggregates all our directions, and jitne zyada users hai GPS mein, that much more you are accurate. So likewise, ratings gives me an indication. It is not my fatwa. Aisa nahi hai ki rating ye hai, to ye achha hona hi hai. Without taking names, there are AAA corporates where we have zero exposure. There are AA corporates, we have 100% exposure. It is only an indicator. It is not a necessary, it is not a sufficient condition. It is a necessary condition. So I think I'm not getting into this risk management process, and also bottom line is that should you invest in debt? The answer is that I'll give you a rainy day example. Barsaat ho rahi hai bahar, you have two options. You can wear a wind cheater or a raincoat or a rainwear kind of a thing, or you can use an umbrella. You can wear gum boots, high boots, or you can wear normal rain oriented shoes. So the option is that you have to carry something with you. But iska ye matlab nahi hai ki, you know, if one side of the market is going good, I'm going to be invested only in one side of the market. What I'm trying to say is, again, let me give you an example, because this presentation is largely done. In 2009, you know, when the UPA came to victory, May 2009 is when the UPA government came to power. Uske pehle we had December 2007, where it was a peak of the market. Jan 2008, 21, 22,000 Nifty Sensex pahunch gaya tha, and people said, "Arey, ab to ye 40,000 pahunch jayega, 50,000 pahunch jayega," and then we know what happened. At that point in time, there was excessive greed in the market, and everybody literally wanted to even sell his house and buy equity. Then comes 2009, where you felt like selling everything and getting into cash. So these were extreme behaviors. So my point is that if you want to have a balanced portfolio, jaise hum bolte, we have to wear the balancing hat or you have to do the balancing hat, it is inevitable that you have both debt and equity in the portfolio. It is like a balanced diet. Aap koi restaurant mein jaate ho, when you order for a thali, I mean, every day eating the same roti sabzi is very, very boring, which is why if you see the thali, it has got a proper platter. It's got a sabzi, it's got a protein, it's got a dal, it's got a calcium, it's got some calories, it's got some carbs, mithai bhi hai. Aisa nahi hai ki aapko mithai pasand hai, toh excessively mithai khate raho. Then you know what happens to your tummy. So the point is that equity and debt has to coexist as part of your portfolio. And how do you decide, yaar, main kitna equity rakhu, kitna debt rakhu? My point is very simple. Assuming my age and your age is the same, my body constitution and your body constitution is the same. But your diet plan and my diet plan is visibly different. So how do I know that what is my diet plan? Again, there are two options. You can go to Google. Say, Google, are Google is available for free. Sab kuch free pe milta hai. Or you can say that, and then I'll chart out my, or you go to a dietitian and pay for that. So who is your dietitian here? Your dietitian is your advisor. So go to your advisor because, and I just saw this tagline saying that BellWether advisors, your personal CFO. Now this is where most of us, for example, when we go to the gym, we say, yaar, humko ye, aisa normal nahi chahiye, we want a personal trainer. Because each person's body construct is different. Each person's risk appetite is different. But my limited submission, and that is where I will leave this room with, and we are well in time, is that you cannot ignore debt at any count. I am not saying that we are not at the cusp of a booming economy. Equities are likely to do extremely well after some near-term consolidation or correction. But I strongly believe that you might be a fan of dal chawal, but that does not mean every day you consume dal chawal. At some times, it makes sense to shift to roti sabzi, and that's what debt and equity will do to your portfolio. Thank you.
Thanks.
So do we have time for Q&A or we don't have?
Any questions anybody want to ask?
I'm sorry?
Percentage of debt and equity. Should it be aligned to your age? Should it be aligned to your... Just a ballpark.
So I honestly don't, I'm not a very personal fan of this 100 minus age, you know, which has been used very, very colloquially. The only reason being that you might be a 35-year-old person, but you need to buy a house in next maybe 1 year or so. So your risk appetite for equity is very low. But you might be a 45-year-old gentleman and you do not require the money for the next 10 years. So there you can have a higher proportion of equity in your portfolio. So what decides how much debt, how much equity? See, equity is the riskier asset class. Riskier because with it's like wine, you know, as it ages, it is better. So if you see 1 year return for the last 20 years, the tendency of negative return could be higher. But if you see 3 years and 5 year return, matlab aapne 20 saal ke last 20 years mein, whenever you would have invested in equity, over a 5 year period, you've never made negative returns. So it is like old wine, as I said, the older the better. So my suggestion would be that obviously you have an advisor to guide you through, but as a ballpark, you have risk appetite and you have money to spare for longer horizons, then overweight your portfolio to equity. And to that extent, debt will be, so equity will be your cake and debt will be the icing. But the moment you say that, you know, I have immediate near-term capex, education, ye wo wagera, and then you have to plan those finances, then obviously equity has to play second fiddle, but still you need to have equity. But then actually debt becomes your cake and icing jo bhi thoda bachta, that will be equity.
Do you think you use the word balanced? I think that's struck well.
Yeah.
So using a balanced fund, you know, where you have equity and debt both.
Yeah.
And since you're dealing with mutual fund, let's say I'm saying mutual fund.
Yeah.
So we are not deciding, and I think one has to grant that they have, will have the best brains and they are the market.
Sure.
Let's say they're on the ground.
Uh huh.
So do you think that balanced fund is a better bet?
Absolutely. So balance is like a twin advantage, or it's like a sone pe suhaga kind of an opportunity where you are able to blend the two things together. So it is like, you know, doing a work cum pleasure kind of a trip. If you are able to blend the two, nothing like it. Because I don't see anything wrong in the strategy. Most balanced funds are in the band of 70 to 80% kind of equity. Just be wary of funds in the name of balance end up doing maybe 90-95%. Usse thoda dur rahiyega because they are nothing like diversified equity funds. But otherwise, doing a balance which has got an optical allocation towards equity and fixed income is absolutely welcome. No worries about it.
Business improving,
right?
Because the cost of funding will less.
Yeah, yeah.
How will, as a fund manager, the debt will perform?
Right. So we are expecting that today the benchmark rates in the country, you know, the overnight rates are at 6.25%, which is the repo rate. We expect this rate to come down by 0.5%. 25 tranches each between now and maybe June 2017. So that's about 6-8 months from today. That would mean that the entire yield curve, right from maybe 6 months, 12 months to maybe 30-year assets, their prices have got the potential to increase by at least 3 to 4 rupees from the current juncture. So the longer, the better. So therefore, as a trade, we are suggesting to investors that if you have a fixed income, mane samjho aapko 100 rupees lagana hai, and assuming that 100 rupees has to go into fixed income, we are suggesting to investors that have maybe 70 to 80 rupees in a combination of short-term duration funds and corporate bond funds, you know, which have high proportion of corporate bonds in the portfolio, and maybe 20-25 rupees in bond funds which run long duration. Why only 20-25 rupees, you may ask, if the interest rates view is so bullish? That is because you might drive the best car, but you need airbags, right? So that airbags is your 70-80% of the portfolio. So the airbags are required for your bad days. Matlab, you might be the best driver, but who knows, road accidents are very common. So if there is a risk to the view going wrong, the 70-80% will give you a huge cushion on the portfolio and not make your portfolio on the debt side very, very volatile. So 70-80% in short plus corporate bond kind of strategies, which we call colloquially as accrual strategies, and the balance in bond funds, I think will give you a good risk mix. In terms of returns, again, there is no writing on the wall types, but a ballpark estimate is that if interest rates in the country come down by 0.5%, and I am running and you are invested in a portfolio of bonds with 6-7 years kind of duration, or maybe 10 years of maturity, I think the arithmetically doing a 10 to 11% return pre-tax is not impossible over the next 12 to 15 months. The unfortunate bit in India is that in debt, long term is 3 years and equity is 1 year. So I think we have to adjust for that. Yeah.
I have a small question. See, people who tend to hoard cash, they keep it in big denominations.
Correct.
It used to be 1,000 rupees.
Right.
Now the government has come up with a 2,000 rupees.
Right.
How does it help to reduce corruption or that thing?
It's very valid. No, I agree. It's a very valid question. It's like this, you know, you serve me tea or you serve me milk, chalo, because the color is the same, okay? I drink the milk, or maine apni jeep jala li. I burnt my tongue so badly and I'm so scared now that you serve me buttermilk now, wo bhi main phook phook ke piyu. So that is one analogy just to tell you. But the point I'm trying to tell you is that that doesn't mean that 2,000 rupees will not mean more hoarding in the system. But our view is that, and of course, there is no right or wrong about it, it's just a conjecture, that the intensity of this will come down quite dramatically. It is not wrong to hold money, but declare a source of income from where you're getting money, like this doctor friend and my architect friend, who are earning loads of money, but obviously not obviously disclosing it. And it's people like you and me who are subsidizing that by paying 30% tax. So I'm not saying that the economy will complete. So again, from a black money perspective, 2007 IMF says that 23% of India's GDP was black money. That number is now 25%. Mota moti number ke hisab se it is $500 billion. How much can that come down? I do not know. Your guess is as good as mine. But our sense is that logo ki itni, if I can use the word, band baji hui hai, that they will actually reduce the intensity of hoarding, but it will not completely get eliminated. Yeah.
Right. That is what we had in mind. Because you see, we have done it one time in 78.
Right.
When 1,000 rupees note was banned.
Right.
But after that, 30 years down the line,
right,
we have seen more hoarding go up.
Right.
Again.
Right.
So can somebody tell them not to have the 2,000 rupees note at all?
No, that 78, no, sorry, 78 mein there were 10,000 rupee notes, for example.
Yes,
but
yes.
Wo jo high denomination note today, currency in circulation, jo CIC, which we all hear about, that is money with people like you and me, not in the banking system. 87% of that is 500 and 1000 rupee note. That number was nowhere near this number in 1978. Size we are today size to theek hai wo to growing denominator
no but the impact obviously what didn't happen in 78 or in 46
absolutely yeah yeah
it will be 4 times or 10 times today
we are a $2 trillion dollar economy and usme $500 billion is a magnitude and as I said now I'm one moment I'm willing to probably forego the size of the economy but what disturbs or that number was disturbing is that 87% of 17 lakh crores is 500 and 1000 rupee notes. So I think that is where the bigger concern was. So to answer, and I do not know, it could be a plan up RBI sleeve ki yaar, theek hai, jitna 2000 rupiya note aapne chhod diya, utna chhod diya. You have a curbed restriction of the amount of 2000 rupees note you would circulate in the system. We never know because it is yet early days. You know, it's very teething trouble. So you do not know that.
But that would depend on inflation, isn't it? Because if inflation,
inflation.
Because if inflation is high, you need bigger denominations to run your economy.
So the only good news here is that the backbone of inflation is broken for the foreseeable future. So RBI has targeted 5% inflation by March 2017. We anyways had a view that it will undershoot RBI's expectation. I will not be surprised if it significantly undershoots RBI's expectation. As I told you, this is a new normal. This is a new normal, and no chartist who are deemed artists can actually tell you what will be the future of this, because it can have significantly, I would say, not life-changing, but country-changing implications.
And moreover, I think it will bring down the RBI's liability also, the amount of money in circulation, which is not getting
absolutely,
back to RBI.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
Let's park a few questions for tea time.
Yeah. And then, thank you so much.
Thanks.
Excuse me. Can I just one more question?
Yeah, yeah.
The typical returns on equity were almost about 15-16% over the last 5 years.
Right.
And debt was about 9-10%.
Right.
And FDs were again about 7% or so.
Right.
So what do you expect now in the coming times when the interest rates are going to come down?
Right.
And equity or the business is going to perform well in
right.
the coming next 4 or 5 years.
Right.
So the ratios of returns, won't it change dramatically?
To answer that, it depends on the time horizon. If you ask me next 3 years,
I'm 5 years.
5 years, I think equity is going to be all out winner. There's no two ways about it, because India is still, even I assume 0.5% gets shaved off from GDP, 0.75, jo bhi number ho, I don't know what the numbers are. But I think out and out equity is going to be the winner, because we are the fastest growing economy
so
today in the world.
That means it could be around 20% plus.
If I knew that, I would not be working with Kotak. But let me just tell you a broad arithmetic, okay? Broad arithmetic, which is just a rule of the thumb. The rate at which your country grows, which is approximately, say, 7% for now, and the rate at which inflation grows in your system, which I will assume right now, say, 5%. Un dono ko jod do, that is the broad expectation that you need to have from equity markets over the next 5 years. Uske upar aapko jo bhi mila bonus.
So, and debt would be much less?
Debt would be, to my sense, again, this is I'm talking about on a post-tax basis. Debt would be, so let me put it this way. It is fair to expect a gross return jo aapko FD mein milta hai aaj ki tarikh mein, and the post-tax, post-index return in debt funds to be almost equal. So I think that...
So that means the gap is increasing between equity and debt.
It's highly possible, no? Because on a lower base, to be able to generate high returns will that become that much more difficult. And there is another science to this. A 1% drop in interest rates improves corporate performance or corporate earnings by almost 5%. So that obviously will have a compounding effect. So I manage debt funds, but obviously for my investments, and if it's 5 years as your case, I'm a very big fan of equity.
So that means I think you're going to have a tough job with the debt management.
No, but we still have our jobs to spare, because the banking industry is 100 lakh crores. And as I said, you know, you're going to have a thali. You can't have continental every day. Thank you.